Hey, today it's my privilege to welcome into the CBMC offices Doug Spada. You know, we've been talking about the concept of an integrated life, a life where we are the same on Monday morning as we are on Sunday during our time and in our place of worship. And I am just delighted to have found an absolute kindred spirit here in Doug and the work that he at Work Life has been doing. You know that we have featured Monday Morning Atheism as a resource. And I thought it'd be great today just to have a little bit of time together with Doug here in the office to talk about how did Monday Morning Atheism, how did the idea of stopping the switch really come to you based on your experience in the marketplace and the things that you've discovered? And an exciting thing for me is discovered through real research, not just kind of a gut feeling or idea, but the sense that this is what's going on and this is what we have to deal with. And so at CBMC here, we are excited to partner with Doug and to talk about how we can challenge the believer in the marketplace to literally take God at his word and be all that they can be in the marketplace. So tell me a little about how did it come about that you got into this whole deal?
Sure, Lee. First of all, I'd just like to say it's great to be here with you and your staff, and just wonderful partnering with you, and to just spread the gospel and help people to keep God on in the workplace. But Monday Morning Atheist, the concept of Monday Morning Atheist really came from my own personal experience. I was in the marketplace running a company for a lot of years, and although I loved God and I wanted to serve God, I would all the time find areas that I would switch him off or go through a whole day or a couple days and realize, where was God? And specifically when I had decisions to make or financial decisions, I would find that I would switch God off. So about 10 years ago, we started a ministry out of San Diego called Work Life. Our mission is to help people find life in work, because as you know and you hear in all your travels, work for a lot of people sucks the life out of them.
Sure.
So we want them to realize that God can give you life in your work. So Monday Morning Atheist was really a research project based upon curiosity of why is it that people that love God and want to serve Him, why is it that they switch God off? So for about 7-8 years, we did research, and we cataloged and found we have about 300,000 data points on what makes Christians switch God off at work. So we put that into a form of the book Monday Morning Atheist, along with online tools to help people keep God on at work.
And so as you all realize this message, the fact that we do at times disconnect in the marketplace and we do shut God off to some degree, it resonated with me. For years in corporate America, I played by one set of rules on Sunday and enjoyed a great church life, a great men's group, involved even in adult Sunday school, so whole nine yards. But on Monday morning, I'd arrive at HP in a Fidelity Investments office, and I would just see a whole different set of rules. And suddenly, there was something about that where the switch went off, to your point, and I behaved and acted in a different way.
From the research, we actually created a profile.
Okay.
So it's a free profile that anybody can get to at stoptheswitch.com.
Okay, great.
They can take the profile, and we actually use the 30 top issues that we found from our research, okay? That we kind of call them, they're the top propensities for somebody to switch God off.
Okay.
And they're geared around some biblical principles. I mean, it can be things like gossiping or compensation discontentment. A lot of people, they're not making enough, or they're just struggling with that, and it causes them to switch off. Or they're having struggles with their boss or submitting to different things. There's just a whole slew of things. I personally found that I'm struggling with probably about 7 of them to some degree or another. Some of them have to do with how do you actually talk about Jesus in the 21st century marketplace. So we catalog those, and then after a person gets that profile, they can actually get access to resources to actually help resolve some of those.
Great. And so I've talked a lot about in past times expectation. That's a big word for me, because I found that when I would arrive at work, sometimes my expectation that God was even interested in what I'm doing here in the marketplace, and of course we know that's a lie of the enemy. That's just not true. God is, our work matters to God, and that's something that I think your research and so forth helps to flesh that out, that God is absolutely interested in who I am in the marketplace.
Underneath all those kind of issues that actually we have to face, there's 3 kind of core drivers or beliefs, okay? One of them is what we call spiritual schizophrenia. And that's just the belief that only some of life is spiritual. And we all can,
we all relate to that. Absolutely.
You know, where that's what you were saying. We kind of switch it off, or we sort of play TV dinner Christianity, where we kind of like segment things in different styles. The other one is something you just alluded to, which really plagued me. And that is, do I really believe that God will act on my behalf? And so what that driver we call the absent God.
Oh, interesting.
And that is the underlying belief that if it's going to get done, I got to do it. Mm. And I've got to push it. And I know for a lot of business leaders in your network and stuff, that's something that constantly plagues us. But and I learned that lesson hard through business, where I lost a lot of money not listening to God, or starting off wanting to listen to God and worshiping Him and thanking Him for this, but then slowly I would start separating the business decision from my faith. And we call that the absent God, man, because I just guess did not believe that God would act on my behalf.
Now, tell me about this. I went into the marketplace some days and I said, you know what, I've been here before, I know how the script goes, I'm living the movie, I got this one. And it was almost as if I said to God, I got this one under control, I know how this works. Yeah. And yet in the back of my mind, there's this little gnawing thing where God says, okay, go ahead, but there's a better way. And I think the great thing about Monday Morning Atheism and some of the truths you're revealing through the Stop the Switch campaign is the fact that there is a better way.
Yeah, there is. And it's sometimes not just about actually switching God off. Sometimes we see believers say, you know what, I'm not just switching God off, but just like the case that you just shared, sometimes it's almost like a dimmer switch. So you actually dimmed it down because of sometimes our own arrogance, or we got it, like you said, or I've seen this so many times, I can do it blindfolded. And we sort of lose perspective, and so subtly we switch God off. And so and none of this is meant, you know, the word atheist, I mean, we know that most of the people watching this are not atheists.
Yeah, that's not a category they're going to jump to.
Yeah, but Monday Morning Atheist is defined as someone who loves God and wants to serve Him, but switches God off at work.
Yeah.
And I think all of us understand what that feels like. I think the majority of the body of Christ. So it's really about helping people get an awareness of where they're doing that, and then taking some simple steps forward to start keeping God top of mind. See, if you would have walked into your workplace at Fidelity and actually in those times at least had mechanisms or great resources like CBMC has to actually keep God top of mind, it may have been a little different.
Yeah. And I think, you know, we can talk about this a little bit too. And please understand, I am an absolute lover of God's church, the gathering of believers together on Sunday. But I think we hear so little about who I am on Monday when we're at church on Sunday that we kind of, the dimmer switch is almost a natural default position because I haven't made the connection.
That's right. Yeah, and that's, as you know, Lee, I have a lot of personal experience in that because work life was actually developed out of my pain in that area. I ran a company in San Diego, but I just could not bridge that gap. And I had a very dynamic church, but I would go into the marketplace on Monday, and it was almost, and this is a, you know, an interesting way to think about it. Without addressing this intentionally, in our churches and in our organizations, we accidentally, most of the time, we breed Monday morning atheists. We switch to a form of practical atheism that we never intended to do, and we would not say that we would like it, but we're not sure about how to get out of it. But I did have experience where I would communicate that. I never heard it taught, preached, or anything in the church. And I as I tell pastors around the country, I came disillusioned and sort of disconnected from the mission of the church, when the real mission of the church was to equip the saints for the work of ministry.
Absolutely, yeah.
And that's where we had most of our influence, and I saw people come to Christ. And so I had trouble bridging that gap, but we've also been helping churches over the last 10 years kind of shift that and actually communicate that clearly.
Great.
And keep intentional process in place to actually help, you know, equip the saints.
Listen, I know that you are good intentioned and love God and you want to make this connection. I'm just telling you how natural it was for me to disconnect. Yeah. And so it's important that we have some tools and resources, and I think, frankly, an accountability team behind us that keeps us accountable to dealing with these issues head on. That's how we're going to be the most effective in the marketplace. We have an enemy that would love us to not figure this out, and I'm committed to figuring it out with you.
I think I would just encourage the constituents of CBMC to think out of the box. It's a new day in CBMC. It's a new day on the earth. I mean, God's doing new things, and He's creating new ways that we can actually communicate to people. And so God developed Monday Morning Atheist. He even gave us the title, the everything. So it's all for His glory. Mm. And so we have just seen people using creative concepts, because there's not anybody that sees this or that we share with it doesn't all of a sudden just almost kind of raise their hand and say, yeah, me too, just like you heard from Lee. So think new, think out of the box, and use the creative resources that CBMC is kind of bringing to your people to actually reach people for the glory of God.
Absolutely. So the message, the mission, the vision for CBMC has not changed. But as we come across things like the provocative messages of Monday Morning Atheism, where we can literally challenge other believers in the marketplace to align behind the important mission that we do have, and that is, as you know, to present Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord to the business and professional man, and to train him to live out the Great Commission within his sphere of influence. And so I want to thank you for being with us.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I know we're going to have a lot more opportunities to share and to talk and to develop things. The creative juices are flowing here at CBMC. They've been flowing at Work Life. We're just excited for the partnership that God is bringing together. And it's all in the vein to help you be as effective as possible in reaching the world with the gospel of Jesus Christ.